Hello, second graders. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about STEM. STEM stands for projects that use science, technology, engineering, and math. An easier way to explain this is that in my classroom we build solutions to challenges using classroom materials. However, what's really important in my class is what we learn on the side, and those are the 21st century skills of communication, collaboration, creativity, and critical thinking. Communication is practiced through teamwork. When you have to share materials with a classmate, you're forced to share your thinking by talking with them. Collaboration means working with someone to create something. As we work in teams, we have to collaborate to build one prototype, which we also can call a model. Creativity is using your imagination to create original work. Sometimes I also call this divergent thinking because I want people to come up with as many possible ideas as they can and not just go with their first idea. When we're able to think divergently, we've brainstormed lots of possible solutions to a challenge. We use critical thinking skills when we analyze how well our solution performed. Sometimes when we're looking critically at our solution's performance, we can identify flaws in our prototype and we can fix them and then retest our revised solution. Those are four big skills that we're always working on whenever we complete an engineering task. You probably don't remember this, but back in kindergarten, the first time I had you work with a partner, I paired you up and I gave you each a small bin of wooden planks and asked you to build the tallest tower that you could. You all knew the goal was to build the tallest tower, but you didn't have these 21st century skills yet. So throughout all of my six kindergarten classes, I saw the same thing happen over and over again. The two partners would each build their own tower, slowly realizing that they were running out of materials. So they'd build faster and faster so they could use more planks than their teammate, even though you were supposed to be working together. Sometimes this would lead to an argument and occasionally tears. Oftentimes you'd ask me for more blocks and I'd explain that you had to build the tallest tower possible using only the blocks you were given. When I limit your materials, this is called a constraint and it mimics real life. In real life, when you're building something, you're limited by time, by money, and by materials. However, in kindergarten, you were stuck and you just considered the task done because you'd run out of materials and you didn't consider reusing them in a different way. A few months later, we repeated that same lesson. You'd had several times at this point to practice teamwork. This time, the light bulb went off, and you realized that in order to build a tall tower, you had to work together and share the limited materials, you had to communicate a plan, you had to collaborate to build a prototype, and use creativity and critical thinking skills to consider how the blocks could be used to gain the most height, yet still create a well-engineered structure that wouldn't fall over. And this time, you knocked it out of the park. In later years, I'd give you similar challenges, but force you to think creatively. For example, last winter, I gave you 40 wooden planks and asked you to build the tallest tower you could up to six different times. Each time, you had to build a tower that looked different. As you continued working, you had to use your creativity to come up with original ideas and critical thinking skills as you considered how to use some of the planks in an upright position, even though this made them more wobbly. You had to think about how many of them you could balance in that upright position before the tower became structurally unstable and fell. So STEM is about engineering solutions to challenges, but there are often even more valuable skills we're working on than just who can build the tallest tower.